Welcome to E Pathshala. Today we are going to learn about a new module called Kitchen Layouts. A kitchen is an enclosed space in which the edible food materials are processed into unique dishes which are preferred by the customers. It is the hub of food production activity in any institutional food service establishment. The planning of kitchen space and allotment of equipments play a crucial role in the efficient work output. As kitchen is the heart of the food service establishment, planning has to be done meticulously to avoid unnecessary workout and energy expenditure. Objectives: this chapter is intended to assist the students learning how to organize the kitchen layout design in an effective manner, the important criteria to be considered for effective planning, and the different types of kitchen that exist in the commercial outfit. Now, let's see what are the sizes and types of kitchen available in the commercial outfit. Planning a kitchen area is depend upon the size and type of kitchen. Usually, the space allotted is approximately half of the dining area. It's usually 40 to 45% of the dining area. If the kitchen is provided in a very big hotel, it should be 33% of the dining area. If it is in a bakery shop, the kitchen must have to occupy 20% only. The space allotment is usually 7 square feet per guest room. As a rule, it is a good practice to provide compact arrangement to avoid unnecessary time and effect for walking, stretching and pending. So, 2.5 to 3 meters is enough for a single person who works in a kitchen, whereas 2.5 to 5 meters is good for two people who are working in a kitchen. Spaces in the kitchen could be used by a single purpose or several purposes. So it is important to understand the need of work area that has to be allotted adequately to construct a comfortable kitchen. Hence, a kitchen may take several shapes according to the shape, spaces available and nature of food services. Generally, it has six types based on its shapes, as square-shaped kitchen, rectangular kitchen, U-shaped, L-shaped kitchen, parallel kitchen, single or straight line kitchen with varying dimensions. Now, let us see the types of different shaped kitchens in detail. Square-shaped kitchen. It is not a common type of kitchen, even though it's a square-shaped. It is very difficult, as it is very difficult to use the center space, it is not commonly preferred. All plumbing and electricity go and gas connection must have to come in the middle, so it has to go down the floor and it may create inconvenience at the time when any leakage may happen, the kitchen may get flooded up. So it's not a very successful model. Rectangular kitchen. It's a common shape which is preferred by most of the food service establishment. It is generally used in a busy hotels where most of the time the day is being engaged in the kitchen. Most of the multi-cuisine kitchen prefer this kind of shape. Example of this kind of kitchen exist in hospitals, star hotels, airport and industrial kitchen. U-shaped kitchen. It's a type of kitchen which is very compact in nature and which is also preferred by all, which is a step-saving module. The door which is present in the kitchen is also at the end of the U, and the dining area will be surrounded by this kitchen. This is a very shapes space saving kitchen. It has no confusion while walking and there will be a free flow of pattern. The counters can also be fixed at the adjacent sites for the convenience of service. Another type of kitchen is called L-shaped kitchen. It makes the use of wall adjoining at the right angle. It is an efficient kitchen where less floor space is available. Extra space can also be created by using a foldable shelves in this basic kitchen. It is a very suitable kitchen for small canteens, kiosks, tea shops and coffee shops. Parallel kitchen. Parallel kitchen is another type of kitchen which uses the sides of passages. Maybe center of the space will be an aisle. The passage may be slightly screened off on one side and the service during the peak hours will be tea. This type of kitchen is best suited for cafeterias where the self-service is being offered as a service. This shape is suitable for midday meal scheme where the dining facility are not possible. The central passage with walls at least 1.2 to 1.5 meters apart can be used by the children to squat their mattresses and eat their plated foods on the floor. Most often, children like to eat standing or playing or so carry the food away from this. So this type of kitchen is most preferred by food service outlet in the midday meal. And the last type of kitchen is straight line kitchen. This is sometimes referred to as an eye-shaped kitchen. It is useful, very much useful for the arrangement of kiosk, tea shops, straight line kitchen, mobile vending units. The extra storage is created on the walls or under the sinks through cabinets. For service, there is a provision for platform or extended counter outside a window. Window spaces can be shelved and covered with wire meshes, shutters to increase the display space and protect from flies, where at the same time providing enough ventilation in small spaces. Apart from all the above said space shapes, combination of space shapes can also be applied. Any two or three shapes could be combined to create a more modern kitchen. This is a very combinative kitchen, but it's not adopted by all type of organizations. Maybe this type of kitchen evolves out of renovation process. Developing kitchen plans. Kitchen plans can be developed by using the four main steps. Formulating list of activities to be performed will be the first step of this kitchen planning. And breaking down the activities into job is very important as the next step. Working out the simplest way of performing the tasks is the next step. And arranging the tasks into sequences for smooth operation. Now let's see what is the steps, what are all the important aspects to be followed under step 1. Formulating list of activities that are to be performed in the kitchen first step. In this process, you will have to schedule the activities that are to be organized into production cycle, which shows the sequence of activities that are listed to be performed. And in step 2, each part of the production cycle is then broken up into jobs or tasks, which need to be performed in a particular order to achieve the objectives of the food service establishment. For example, if the menu of the canteen exists, some consist of small cakes or hot and cold beverages, a plated meal and sandwiches. Each activity can be broken down into specific tasks for every item on the menu. Similarly, the tasks required for preparing hot and cold beverages, sandwiches, meals can be clearly defined. Step 3. Once the tasks have been defined, you will have to think of the simplest ways by which you can perform the job. Step 4. The tasks that are arranged in sequence so that one can smoothly follow the other tasks. It has to be established in a flow diagram. Similarly, the diagram can be worked out for the canteens, lunchrooms, restaurants. A smooth workflow not only simplifies work, but also cuts down the wastage of energy, time by reducing confusion and noise in the kitchen. This is how you'll have to plan your kitchen. Now, I'm going to teach you how to simplify the work, because work simplification is the very important area of production, that production and production induced happenings inside the kitchen. One of the goals of human engineering is the prevention of fatigue. The manager of a food service cannot afford to have fatigue among the workers, as it is directly related to reduce the output. Any responsible person of a food production institution, any fine fatigue and tiredness of some kind of works within the restaurant, drop in the energy, enthusiasm, and results in production output, poor production output. These are all due to the external factors such as home situation or a nutritionally inadequate or food inadequacy due to many internal sources. Of course, some external sources also beyond one's control. However, within the food service, while the worker are in the job, there are said to be unlimited opportunities for the causes of fatigue, and they are certainly detrimental for the sources of the food service, and hence they need to be corrected at once. Work can be simplified by viewing the kitchen and its activities from the five different aspects, namely work area, workers' area of reach, workspace, equipment, materials, supplies, and movements at work. Work area. This refers to the area of work surface that is high from the floor, location of the equipment. Working height while standing must be just below the waistline, so you don't need to bend much. The surface heights also to be planned while considering workers' area. Always, sink top height must be around 90 to 100 centimeter. and gas stove top will be little lesser than the top, that is 80 to 90 centimeter. The height of the highest shelf will be always 180 centimeter, and the top of the highest unit will be 225 centimeter. And you have to plan the shelf under the work surface must be around 80 to 85 centimeter. If you keep the heights like this, you will get the following advantages. You can avoid muscle strain, you can avoid accidents, you can get the physical comfort, and you can provide social well-being of your employees, and you can get the better output also. Now, how to arrange workers' area of reach? The limit by which the person can reach the area or by his hand or by grasping a material is called workers' area of reach. If the arm is extended fully outward from a circle, it is called normal reach. Always normal reach must be 85 to 90 centimeter. If the person puts some effort to reach that area, will be called as effective reach, which must be always around 145 centimeter. But when you put more effort, it will be called as maximum reach. It will be around 215 centimeter. So you will have to arrange things on the shelves according to the reach area. Always all the simplest items have to be kept in a normal reach. The items that are not generally be taken or quite often should be kept in the maximum reach. And all the items that are taken very optimally has to be taken in the average reach. Now, how to keep the movements and work in the workers' area? One needs to become conscious of how body movements are related to the amount of energy consumed. For this, it is necessary to understand that the body has been designed so that it is weights evenly distributed over the legs. When working in any position, standing or seated, the center of gravity of the body is disturbed. This causes unequal distribution of weight on the legs, resulting in extra energy consumption to maintain the body's position. If the balance is continuously disturbed in any activity, muscle may get tired and fatigues and sets on. For all positions at work, therefore, one must keep the body in physical balance. That is, maintain a correct posture to enhance the comfort and conserves energy. In addition, the muscles of the body are so arranged so that the large muscles occur at those points in the body which are meant to take up maximum strain. So it's always comfortable to arrange your muscle, keep your body's position according to the worker's area. So it's the duty of the manager to make the arrangement of the working area without much strain and pain. Workspace. The amount of space available for work is important for completing tasks efficiently. The space should be large enough to place all the materials and equipments required so that you can allow the movement of work. In addition, extra space is necessary for placing the completed work. For example, in making a salad, number of vegetables or fruits may need to be cut. So it has to be allowed in that working area in the normal reach. Finally, all parts of the salad would have been put together before be served. That has to be allotted with a space. Insufficient workspace while preparing a salad may result in a poor salad. The next important aspect is equipment, materials and supplies. The energy used to work depends upon two important factors: location of the equipment in the working area and the manner of storage. So, as per the requirement of your energy saving, you will have to locate the equipments and the storage of equipments also to be done within your body's comfort will enhance your work output. Now, how to design the kitchen layout? Designing the kitchen layout involves number of steps and also number of factors. Now, I'm going to teach you what are all the general factors to consider while designing the kitchen layout. Physical aspects. The physical aspects like location, structural details, layout have to be considered very importantly while planning the kitchen. Location. Location is nothing but the position of the kitchen in relation to the rest of the building. As far as the kitchen is concerned, it has to be adjacent to the service area, preferably one corner of the building, that is northwest portion of the side. This will be always convenient, so by the natural light and air will come in. The next one is structural feature. The drainage, electricity and gas connections and water supplies all to be provided adequately without disturbing the infrastructure of the kitchen. That has to be done in prior. Drainage. Drainage system determines the hygiene and sanitation of the kitchen. Poor drainage may result in the poor quality of the food output. So drainage have to be always closed, and it has to be ducked under the soil, and it has to be properly sealed so that you can avoid leakage during the working time. In electricity is very important. Electricity connections have to be considered in the kitchen. It is very important. It has to be given for all the equipments and non-equipments. Now let's move on to the work surfaces. All the work surfaces should be hard-wearing, smooth and impervious. Stainless steel is by far the best among the work surfaces in the kitchen, so that the cleaning will be very convenient. Work surfaces can be covered by laminated plastics, hardwoods, ceramic tiles also. It can avoid the rust and unwanted scratches on the surface. Laminated plastics are quite comfortable for cleaning too. Hardwood work surfaces are also very convenient with a lacquered finish in the kitchen, institutional kitchen. Marble is very, very effective for food service institutions. Lighting must be adequate in order to make the food output better, because light can match the food color, and inappropriate colors may merge the food color and the food quality will not come out in a proper way. Fluorescent lamps lighting is more economical to use filament MPS, because even though initial cost is more, fluorescent light lasts almost 6 times better than any other filament lighting. The color effects of the fluorescence lighting also is very important. High efficient fluorescent tubes reaching the temperature of 3000 to 4000, that may also merges the work output. Ventilation. Adequate ventilation is very important. It reduces the oxygen replacement and thereby it avoids stress and fatigue. So ventilators are very, very important for the kitchen adequately. Vapor extractor hoods are very important on the kitchen. Chimneys can also be placed. What are the kitchen spaces that has to be present in the layout of the kitchen? Operation, kitchen layout, operation. The expert in this field must be able to present essential data accurately, completely and easily understandable form. Therefore, it has to be a food specialist, because he has to approve the plan in the end of on the behalf of the users. The food service manager must have to plan the layout, because of the direction within the layout purely is his responsibility. The plan in question would provide more practical if the kitchen staff were involved in the decision regarding the areas would finally use. Architecture. The expertise of architecture is also vital in planning the layout of kitchen, because it also adds the structure of kitchen. Construction and design engineering is also very important to perform to get a better shape of the kitchen, and also to avoid accidents inside the kitchen. Centers in the kitchen layout. Work centers in the kitchen layout should be positioned within the four basic concepts in mind: smooth workflow, avoidance of congestion in the work tables and sinks, comfortable work environment, hygienic and sanitary condition. Smooth workflow in a kitchen can be easily managed if the sequence of activities to be performed in a clear way. On the basis of the workflow principles and the production cycle, work centers can be established for each production activity. So the institutional kitchen must have to consider the following: preparation center for meat and fish separately, vegetable and fruit separately, cooking center separately, holding and serving unit separately, washing areas must be positioned separately. How to avoid the congestion at the work tables. Faulty design of the work planning may result in accidents during work area. So it has to be considered, like the work area has to be considered as per the requirements of the work surface and workspace allotment. It has to be designed. Improper scheduling of work area may result in increase in time and poor performance. Overutilization of certain piece of equipment and area may result in congestion of work, which also results in a poor quality of work. Very often, frustrated workforce comes together informally around the group leader to a particular center, which results in poor work output. Congestion also will cause us trafficking, and which results in accidents inside the kitchen. Now, provision of comfortable work environment. How can we provide? temperature and humidity of the environment. We'll have to see the temperature of the environment. It should be under control. That is, which because a high or increasing temperature results in altered humidity, which may increases the fatigue and tiredness due to the exhaustion. And also by considering the structural features of for kitchen, you can provide a comfortable working environment. And kitchen decoration is also very important aspect to encourage the workers inside the kitchen. So the kitchen decor must have to be given priority. How to maintain the relationship of the people at the work in the kitchen? With all the above factors taken care of, work environment must have to be comfortable enough with the working people. So all the amenities that are required by the people who are working inside the kitchen have to be provided in an adequate. So for the successful layout planning, it should be important to remember the placement of equipments in the center, units built into the wall, and freestanding equipments rather than the placed on flat on the floor, which is more hygienic. And island layout is easier to clean up than the cleaning areas are very much adjacent to the production area itself. Wet preparation and cooking units must be positioned near the external wall. Walls and flooring should not have sharp turns. Traffic lines used by the staff should not coverage the crisscross. Layout should ensure the food is not handled repeatedly. So all these factors have to be considered in mind to avoid confusions and accidents inside the kitchen. Now to conclude, hope you all have understood what is kitchen and what are the different types of kitchens that are available in the commercial outfits. And there are 4 or 5 types of kitchens available. And some kitchen types are not comfortable for food service at all, like square shaped kitchen, whereas U, T and I shaped kitchens are very convenient for food service, small food service outlets. Rectangular kitchen is very, very convenient for the large food service establishments. And also we have seen all the important factors and points to be considered for planning the layout of kitchen, like lighting, ventilation, workspace, work simplifications, which includes workspace, workers' area of reach, work surface, and all the other important factors such as environmental factors such as ventilation, drainage, and flooring, and all the other amenities which are required by the working personnel inside the kitchen we have discussed in this session. Hope you would have understood clearly what are all the essential requirements of planning a proper kitchen inside a food service establishment. As you all know that kitchen is the core or heart of the food production, where the food is being cooked for the appetite of the cook to satisfy the appetite of the consumers.